Hi, everybody. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and they show us their latest products. Today, I'm joined by Brent Lamm. He is the Senior Worldwide Product Manager at Lenovo. Welcome to the show, Brent.
Thank you so much. Great to be here.
And we usually do software on the show and AI and all that other stuff. We do have some AI-related stuff here, but this is hardware, right?
This is 100% hardware.
Yep. And you represent the ThinkPad group of Lenovo.
Yeah, the commercial product sector under Lenovo, you know, strictly ThinkPad, that's where I'm based.
So I don't have to ask you what ThinkPad is because I think most people know what this is.
I hope so.
But what are you here to show us?
So today I'm here to show you, this is a brand new product for us. You know, it's a next generation product, but it's our compact, thin and light design called the ThinkPad X13 Gen 6. Now this is powered by the AMD Ryzen AI PRO 300 series processor, so packs a lot of punch in a very small form factor.
Yeah, and so who is this really designed for? Is this anybody in the enterprise, or is there specific roles within a department that's going to take advantage of the AMD chip in here?
So there's a kind of a combination of both the AMD chip as well as the hardware, because this is such a thin and light and, you know, very portable device, really goes after people that are mobile. You know, whether it's a hybrid user going back and forth to the office from home, or people that are traveling, whether it's, you know, traveling on public transit, you know, sitting on an airplane, traveling, you know, just around town, or, you know, traveling on a plane and going globally. Anybody that needs a powerful and efficient system, but in a very compact form factor.
All right, so here's a question we ask everybody on the show is like, what problems are you solving? Why should anybody care about this? And in the AIPC space, is it fair to say this is the second generation of AIPCs that were out there? And we're really doing a better job of explaining why people would need an AIPC versus maybe what they did the last time.
Right, and so this is definitely going after that next gen AIPC.
Yeah.
With that AMD Ryzen AI PRO 300 series processor, you're getting up to 50 TOPS or trillions of operations per second on the NPU. So the ability to run multiple AI applications at the same time from a low power standpoint, so it's not draining the performance or draining the battery life out of the system. So, you know, somebody that is going to be mobile, that has to go all over the place, that needs excellent performance, obviously wants, you know, something that's going to be efficient and get extremely good battery life. This is the device that, you know, would really suit their needs well.
All right, so this is now a two-part question, but it's similar. So if people didn't have this system, what would they be doing? Because they could have two options. They could have another AIPC from another brand maker, another chip maker, that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. But then also they might not have an AIPC at all. So can you talk about the benefits if they don't have an AIPC, and then maybe then what differentiates you from some of these other brands?
So, I mean, if somebody didn't have a system like that, a system like this, most likely they would have to carry or lug around a much, you know, larger system. Let's go back 5 years. You know, the pandemic happened, COVID happened. This is a 13-inch device. When COVID happened, people stopped being mobile. People really went home. And so we started seeing declines in that 13-inch mobile market. People were sitting at home. It was work from home, work from couch, work from, you know, wherever, but they were driving around with their system. So we started seeing 14-inch become the absolute sweet spot. Even 15-inch and 16-inch devices were getting more and more run because people wanted a larger footprint if they were only going to use one device.
Right.
But then probably, you know, a year, 18 months ago, we started going down the backside of the pandemic of COVID, you know, really kind of trapping people in those, you know, more static areas. We started seeing people travel a whole lot more. And so people wanted a system that was ultra compact, ultra lightweight, but they still had to have that performance and those features and benefits that they were getting out of those larger systems. So we did not sacrifice on the performance. We didn't sacrifice on the end user experience, but we're giving people that smaller compact design, but still with a punch.
Yeah, okay, so you wanna show some features of the device?
Yeah, I would love to. I mean, first thing, I just wanna hand this to you.
Okay.
Because one of the big things
is how light, wow, that really is. It almost feels like it shouldn't be this light.
It almost feels like a model, but it's a true system. Yeah. And I'll show you that in just a few minutes. So to put this in the most basic terms, this is the lightest ThinkPad we have ever made.
Right.
This is right around the 950 grams, just over 2 pounds. Yeah. Incredibly lightweight. But this being a ThinkPad, still mil-spec tested. This thing is bomb-proof. Spill resistance, dent resistance, yeah. Drop test. We go through all of those same tests like we do on any ThinkPad that we have.
Yeah, the thing with lightweight ones is that my back and my shoulders are usually used to... I know that I have my laptop with me because I can feel it in the backpack. Mm-hmm. I would be worried about that. I'd have to put some extra weight in there
Check every once in a while in the backpack to actually make sure that you actually have it in there.
Yeah.
But
none of that sacrifices battery life.
Then. No. And battery life is a very interesting thing when I get into the specs about this, because you actually have two different options for a battery on the system. If you want to go ultra lightweight, we offer a 41 watt hour battery. If you want to have even more battery life, we offer a 54.7 watt hour battery to increase that overall battery life. So if somebody wants that ultra light design, you go for the smaller battery. If they still want a light design, but just longer battery life, go for the larger size.
Okay.
So before even opening it, with those batteries, it's actually a customer replaceable battery.
Okay.
So you've got four screws on the bottom of the device. You pop off those four screws, the D cover comes right off. You've got two screws on the bottom to take that battery right off. You actually have a QR code on that battery to scan, and it takes you to support at Lenovo.com, so you can order the exact battery you need, and then you can drop it right in there. There's little other tutorials that show you exactly from a augmented reality standpoint how to take out the battery and replace the battery. So there's a lot of helpful tools online to get you up and going again if you were to ever have battery issues.
And that doesn't void the warranty or
does
anything
does not
like
void
that,
the warranty whatsoever.
Get mad about that.
No. Yeah. Traditional ThinkPad black design, we do have the little communication bar up here. And what that does on the device is it allows us to put a larger 5 megapixel plus IR camera without sacrificing the overall screen to body ratio on the design. So with this, we've got much smaller bezels all around the design. And we go up to 87%+ screen to body ratio on a 13 inch system.
Yeah.
Got a new one bar hinge, making it really clean and elegant up against the top. You've got user facing speakers on either side of the keyboard that are powered by Dolby Atmos. We've got the traditional ThinkPad 3-button trackpad and the track point in the middle of the keyboard.
I call it the nub, I'm sorry. The track point, right?
It's the track point. Yeah. And it's the iconic pointing device, navigation device that ThinkPad has been known for 30 plus years now. This does have that traditional ThinkPad keyboard that is industry renowned for the overall typing experience. This does have the AMD Ryzen AI PRO 300 series processor. Yep. You can go up to 64 gig of memory. Now that's dual channel soldered LPDDR5X, super efficient memory. So the time of processes for different applications on the memory itself, super short. That also helps the overall efficiency on the system.
All right. And we're going to talk a little bit more about the chip in a second, right? So we're going to get hooked up here, and we're going to show a demo video of some of the benefits of the chip, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. All right. So just to review, what kind of chip is in this system?
So it's the AMD Ryzen AI PRO 300 series processor, nicknamed Kraken.
Yep.
This is
an NPU, right?
An NPU.
Neural processing unit. Just for the audience who might not know, what's the difference between an NPU, a GPU, and a CPU?
So now we kind of have this triumvirate, or this three-headed monster that is now inside the device of a CPU, GPU, NPU. So CPU being your central processing unit, which is still absolutely critical to the system. It's your fast response, low latency. You type in a quick search, you want an instant answer, that's going to be directed to the CPU. GPU, or the graphics processing unit, also still critical, but you kind of think about like anything creative. If you're trying to go in and do something like a text-to-image creation, even voice-to-image creation, some large language model summarizations, that's going to be coded to a GPU right now.
Yeah.
And the NPU, which is the neural processing unit, which is measured in TOPS, or trillions of operations per second, is a low-power, kind of a background task, really, to help the overall the performance of the system. And we've been, you know, Lenovo, AMD, we've partnered with a lot of third-party independent software vendors, or ISVs as they're known, to offload their tasks to the NPU, so it doesn't, you know, take performance away from the CPU and GPU. I mean, we released a couple of dozen new products every year at ThinkPad, and each time we put out you know, information around battery life on the systems, and we'll say we've got 15 hours of battery life on the system. It's a synthetic benchmark, completely clean image, no applications running. We'll give it to a customer, an end user. They'll come back and say, I'm only getting 5 hours of battery life. Well, in your image, how many applications do you have running?
Right.
I talked to a financial services customer. They had 23 applications running in the background at any one time. And I said, let's dive into this. This is exactly why they were having battery life issues. Now with the NPU and getting these third-party independent software vendors to recode their programs to the NPU, especially security. Security is not something that you're going in and playing with all the time.
Yeah.
It's running in the background. So if they can code those to the NPU and create a more efficient system, it's also going to create a more performance-driven system, because those processors are not being driven to the GPU or the CPU. They're sitting on that low power piece of silicon.
Right.
So one of the applications that I wanted to show you is something that AMD has been working and partnering with a company called BufferZone, which is a security-based independent software vendor. And what they are able to do is look at anti-phishing. So people going and visiting different sites in the commercial setting, making sure that the data and the information for that company remains safe. Now, this does run on the NPU. You have the option of running it on a CPU or GPU, but the goal of this is to run on the NPU, so it runs in the background. And so this processing, running in the low power, then frees up the CPU and the GPU, so you do get better performance on the system, but it also helps extend that battery life. Normally, all these processes are done up in the cloud, but this is now done locally on the system instead of running up in the cloud, which is a much more costly process to do.
Right.
There's also a lot of latency issues when you run these processes up in the cloud. So now doing this on the system, even not even connected, you know, to Wi-Fi at times, making sure that your system, you know, checking the security on your system, you can do it not even connected to Wi-Fi and do it to completely local on the system.
Right. So the big goal for a lot of these end users would be the ability to do a lot of this stuff, offload it to the NPU, but then also not require network connectivity or be connected to the cloud and, you know, the latency that you get sometimes with that, but also the security and the privacy, correct?
Security and privacy is probably the biggest thing around AI right now, making sure that, you know, any connection that you have to your data, which data is the ultimate currency right now. So if you want to have your data, your information, your company's information as secure as humanly possible, and so not connected to the cloud, not connected to the internet, yet still doing some of these AI enablement or AI processes local on the device, that's the best way that you're going to have the best security.
All right, so are this available now, or can people grab some of these things now, or are they coming out soon?
We're about a month away from when these are going to start launching.
But this
launching.
Is when we're recording. I'm not sure. We might be available now.
So May of 2025, that's when they're going to start hitting the shelves or hitting online, and they will become available for people to go and grab and start using.
And you're just going to give me this one, right?
We'll talk about it.
All right, Brent Lamm from Lenovo, thanks again for being on the show.
Thank you for having me. Great to be here.
That's all the time we have for today's episode. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, add any thoughts you have below. Join us every week for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.